Hey guys, this is another section on exponents. Today is all about negative exponents, all right? These are a little different in what we want to do with them. So let's just jump right into the first example here. I'm going to draw a little line just to separate things. This is example number one, and you notice the directions just say represent each number as an equivalent expression, all right? Usually good mathematicians do not leave negative exponents in their answers, all right? So here's all you do. There's not really a lot that's mathematical to it. It's just something like you got to know how to manipulate these. So I'm going to write this same number as a fraction, okay? And if I do that, it's just the number over 1. So right now, the 5 and the negative 3, the 5 raised to the negative 3, that is all in the numerator up there. Okay, and right now I have a 1 in the denominator. Well, here's what I do with negative exponents. If I want to change them to a positive exponent, I take the whole, let's see if I can get a different color here. I take the whole term, the base, and the exponent together. So I take this base of 5 and the negative 3, which is the exponent, I take them together, and all I do is I switch them to the other side of the fraction bar. So now it's in the numerator, I'm going to switch them to be in the denominator. When I do that, it changes that negative exponent to positive. Alright, and what would I have left over up here? Well, I would just have a 1. Alright. So that's all there is to it. This expression right here, 5 to the negative 3, is equivalent to 1 over 5 to the third. That's all it is. Very easy. Alright? So let's try the second one here. Again, I have a base of x and an exponent that is negative. It's negative 3. So I want to know what would be equivalent to that. Well, again, if I write it as a fraction, it would look like that. All right, nothing new, nothing different, nothing exciting. All right, so we want to get rid of that negative exponent. We want to write its equivalent. So all I do is take the base and the exponent, just like I did up there. It's now in the numerator. If I move it to the denominator, it changes the exponent from negative to positive. And there's nothing else that was up here, so I just have a 1 up there. That's it. Right there. It's that easy. Okay? Now, if I don't know how to do that, if I don't know that fact, then, yeah, that's a hard problem because I don't know what I'm doing. But if I know that fact, it's pretty easy. Okay? Well, you say, well, I can't be that easy. I have something harder than that. Well, sure. Okay? We gotta start with some that maybe it starts in the denominator. Okay? This one's already a fraction. Okay, but I want to do the same thing. I want to get that negative exponent to be a positive exponent. Well, if it's starting in the denominator, then we change it across the fraction bar. We change it to the numerator. Right? When I do that, it turns it to the opposite. It turns it to positive. Right? Was there anything else down in there, numerator? Or I'm sorry, down in the denominator? No. So there's still a 1 there. Okay, and if I really wanted to, I can just write that as 8 to the ninth, because 8 to the ninth is the same thing as 8 to the ninth over 1. All right, man, that is easy stuff. We can do it with variables. All right, same thing. I've got a numerator of 1, and I've got a denominator of x raised to the negative ninth. Well, if I want to change that negative to a positive, I simply move this base and exponent to the numerator, and that changes it to a positive. Bam! So not much mathematical there. There's a lot of math going on behind the scenes there. All right, and there's a lot of proof that we could do, and there's a big, long, drawn-out process that we could do, but it all boils down to what I've just shown you. All right, when you change to the other side of the fraction bar, it turns the exponent to the opposite sign. All right, in this case, we're starting with all negative. So I'm going to turn that layer on and turn on the other one here. This is some other problems that you have. So let's try them. Now, be careful with this. This negative 4 is not a power to the 3. See this little symbol right here, this multiplication? That's separating this 3 and this 2, these two bases here. Okay? So let's leave the 3 by itself. It would be in the numerator, wouldn't it? Okay, that would be in the numerator if it was 3 over 1. And I'm just going to write it like that. And I'm going to write it this one as a fraction as well. That'd be that over 1. Okay, but again, I want to get rid of that negative exponent. So, I'm going to change it. All right, I'm going to change the 2 to the negative 4th. I'm going to move that to the denominator, and it changes it to a positive. Alright? Now, I could actually multiply these if I wanted to. I could multiply 3 times 1 and get 3. 1 times 2 to the 4th is 2 to the 4th. And I could keep going. Alright? Let's see. 2 to the 4th. What does that mean? That means 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. That's really 16. Okay? So I could leave it as this one, all right? Or I could evaluate that 2 to the 4th, and I could go to this one. And that doesn't reduce any, so I would stop right there, all right? But it's just a variation of the same thing we did on the other page, all righty? Okay, let's try this one. This is the same problem, but now I have variables instead of numbers, all right? So this is going to be x over 1 times... I think that's big enough there, I'll make it a little bigger, times. Now that y has a negative exponent. That means, oops, I don't want to do that. I want to take that out of there. Sorry about that. Okay, that means I want to get rid of that negative exponent. And I'm going to do the same thing I did up here. All right, the x to the 1st over 1, that's going to stay the same. To get rid of that negative exponent, I'm going to, mess that one up, take that out of there. I'm going to move it to the denominator. And it changes it to be positive. Okay? Now I can multiply those together. X times 1 is x. 1 times y to the 4th is y to the 4th. And since they're variables, I'm not going to change them any. I'm not going to reduce anything. So I'm all done. Right there. Okay? It's that easy. Alrighty? Now this one. Much like the ones from the previous page. So let's write it as a fraction over 1. All right, and I want to write its equivalent, so I want to change this negative 5 to a positive. When I do that, it takes it from the numerator and turns it down to the denominator and changes that to a positive. And I'm just left with a 1 up there because that's the only thing that's up there. Since now it's just 4 raised to the 5th, well, I can do 4 times 4 times 4 times 4 times 4. I think I'm going to get my calculator out for that. I'm going to go 4 raised to the 5th. Ooh, 1024. Glad I got the calculator out. So this would really be 1 over 1024 right there. Okay, and looks like we got a couple more here. Or maybe just one more, okay? Similar to the other page, this is a 9 raised to the negative 4th. It's starting out in the denominator, so I'm going to take it across that fraction bar, and it changes it to a positive. All right, so I went from the numerator to the, I went from the denominator to the numerator, okay? And again, I'm going to get my calculator out again, and I'm going to raise 9 raised to the 4th. It equals, 6,561. So that is really 6,561 over 1, which, again, I could just write as 6,561. And there you go. It's all set. All right. So you have 2 more problems. There's the other 2. 2 more problems. We're going to take care of these right now. Now, be careful. Since our negative 16... there are no parentheses, right? There are no parentheses around that negative 16. So It's like there's this little negative 1 out front. Okay, I'm going to write it as a fraction. All right. And I'm going to leave that negative. This is really like a little negative 1 out here. Okay, times 16 raised to the negative 6. So I'm going to leave that negative 1 up there in the numerator. And I'm going to take this 16 raised to the negative 16 and bring it down there. Okay? And again, those are regular numbers, so I pop up the calculator. I'll move it over a little bit so it's not in the way. And I'm going to go 16 raised to the 6th power. And, oh, that's a big number. Whoops, so I got negative 1 over, what was that number again? Oh, wow, 116,777,216. So 16,770,216. Okay? And I could divide those and it'd make it even, it'd be a mess, but I'm just going to leave it like that. Okay? And let's see, one more we got to go here. Oh, this is super easy. It's just a variable g down in the denominator. We've got a negative exponent. So again, you bring it to the numerator and it changes the exponent to positive, which again, I could just write like that. Alrighty, so negative exponents, really not a lot of math there. It's just knowing, oh wait, if I have a negative exponent, I can take it to the other side of the fraction bar and it turns the exponent positive. That's really what it boils down to. So, hope you enjoyed it. Fill in the note packet. We'll see you tomorrow. See ya.